Hey guys, thanks for checking out the podcast. Before we get started, I want to remind you about the very cool bucket list trip I am doing in 2026, the Smitty Learns Irish podcast, where I'm going to do my bucket list, hike Ireland for a year, learn about Irish history, town by town, through the mouths of the pub owners and regulars. Because what's a better way to learn about something you love than to experience it yourself? Patreon.com/we3smiths, only $3 a month, and thanks for checking it out. Welcome to the Rock Radar. My name is Smitty from the What the Hell Everything podcast, another stoner reaction, and reaction number two to the band Polyphia. And I really wish now that I would have re-listened to the song that I listened to before and reacted to before, because I remember not, I think the vibe was that I didn't really like it because it was fairly techno-y or dubstep-y or something electronic-y, and that typically is not my thing. So the reason I'm giving them a second listen is just because you guys were super cool in the comment section and really said, nah, maybe this wasn't a good representation. You should give them another listen. And I'm going to trust you on this. And let's see, what album is this from? The 2017 album, The Most Hated. It is called 40 Ounces. And I got to tell you, I don't know. I couldn't find up a whole lot of information on this album other than it was in 2017. The song 40 Ounces didn't come up as a single on the Wikipedia page. And I know Wikipedia obviously isn't always correct. But I thought that somebody had said in the comment section that that was their most mainstream song. So now I'm sort of confused, but this is the one I'm going to listen to and react to nonetheless. I'm interested to give it a shot because there was some things I liked about the band. Before I get to the reaction, a real quick, huge shout out to my sponsor, M22 in Sutton's Bay. If you've never been to the beautiful region of Traverse City, Northern Michigan, there's so much to enjoy and a great place to stay. Make your reservations. A cute little bungalow things. I always said to myself, how do I describe this M22 in Sutton's Bay? Is it a hotel or is it a motel? It's an inn, dummy, M22 Inn, Sutton's Bay, with a great view of West Bay, West Grand Traverse Bay, essentially Lake Michigan shores, along the historically gorgeous M22 Drive. So if you're looking to book some vacation time in one of the fastest growing tourist spots in the country, here you go, M22 Inn, Sutton's Bay. Thanks so much. Okay, so this is listen number two, reaction number two to Polyphia. The song is 40 Ounces. And I want to kick this back here. I'll start all over again. I'm trying to really express my thoughts on electronic music. And that's probably just being old and turning into my father. That probably has a lot to do with it. I'm trying to open up that and exercise that rock and roll, open-minded rock and roll muscle. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway. My issue with electronic music, there's some of it I like. I think if you incorporate it well enough in songs, it, like Trent Reznor and Nine Inch Nails obviously is a great example, where you just do it smartly, in the right spots, you know. But once it starts getting, you know, into like club music and dance music and auto-tune, and you lose me at auto-tune, it just happens. It's the worst thing that happened to music in a long time. Personal opinion, obviously. So those are my thoughts. If you could incorporate it correctly, cool. If not, it's probably not what I want to listen to. Runner, Stranger Things. Fucking Tron. They're just riding bicycles, those electronic Tron bikes. fucking groove, I'll give it that. Oh, I like that. I like that fucking riff, just that choppy guitar grooving. I think this was mainly, now that I'm thinking about it, that was, I stopped doing the 2-for-1 reactions. I might go back to that at some point, who knows. But I just like the idea of doing one song at a time. But I think I just remember it being all instrumental, which I'm not typically against. There's a lot of instrumental shit I love. In that case, I was like, I don't know if it was working for me. But I dig this song. Super chill. Real hippie jam bandy shit, that's how it sounds to me. Electronic Hippies. Which has to be a band, right? Electronic Hippies has to be a fucking band name. Quick
fuck
Google
yes
search.
It is.
Let's see. Honestly, let's do an emergency reaction to Electric Hippies after this song is over, of course. But then let's quick listen to Electric Hippies, see if that's worth something. Fuck yeah. Hey, preview of the next reaction. Anyway, I like that. It was okay. I think I liked it better. I would have to go back and listen to those other Polyphia songs again. But I just dug that little vibe. And I was thinking during the last third of that song, I'm like, this would be really fun if I was just getting high and watching fucking space videos, which I do on occasion. And I'm thinking, oh man, I should totally come up with like a playlist for like when I'm, I have several high playlists, but like just one to just watch space videos too. You know, just something to fucking vibe out on. And that's some cool vibing music. So I would absolutely listen to that again. That's one of those songs. I don't know how much I liked it, but I liked it enough to listen to it again. So I guess that's saying something, right? Oh, wait, I did say emergency reaction. Let's see if we can find something from the band Electric Hippies. I did see they were an Australian band, I do believe. And I'm there they are. Let's get some headphones on here. What are we going to listen to? There's top five songs on Spotify. Top five is Acid Lady, I Believe in You, Whole Lot of Rosie. That looks like a fucking AC/DC cover. Man. That would make sense being from Australia. Also, the number one song is called Greedy People. I don't know how much we're going to listen to, but it could be just a bonus fucking reaction. Let's listen to a song from the Electric fucking Hippies, who were an Australian band formed by ex-Noiseworks member Justin Staley and Steve Balby. The pair also used the same name for their production work. So there you go, Electric Hippies. Fucking hell, let's do this. Sounds like fucking Electric Hippies. You can have all the money, take the house, honey. You can even keep the shirt off my back. Well, you think that you can lose, but your attitude just proves. You'd even sell your mother for cash. All right, that was plenty. I think I'm over it. But nice job, Electric Hippies. I appreciate what you did, and I really appreciate that name. So I'm open to more suggestions if you're into that kind of thing. And if you got a band you want to see me react to, your favorite band that nobody knows about, your band here is kind of the idea behind that. But I would say throw it in the comment section. Old band, new band, independent band, who the fuck cares? I don't care. Patreon.com/we3smiths, only $3 a month. And that Patreon site actually gets first right of request for the Rock Radar. Other stuff happened at the Patreon page too, link in description. Can't thank you enough, and have a good one, guys. Thank you. What the hell? Everything!